So generally when people say to themselves they're alone, they're not considering that there might be microbes living on their skin or in their digestive tract. Because if you want to include them, then you're definitely not alone. There are more microbes in one linear centimeter of your lower colon than all the humans who have ever lived and ever been born on Earth. So you're outnumbered by others who are just sharing your own biological form. So typically when people ask, are we alone, they mean other intelligent life. And it presumes that we understand intelligence enough to rank ourselves among others in that category that we might discover. And that's, for me, a debatable question. But let's take it as a given that we are intelligent, we're looking for other species with whom we can communicate. But we haven't found other life, and we're still not sure how we would. So we've got radio communication technology. The good thing about that, of course, is that it can penetrate obscuring gas and dust in space. In the same way radio waves make it into this building, it can move through walls. Radio waves have high penetrating ability, unlike visible light, or other forms of light even. So we send out a signal using radio waves, or we use radio telescopes, as what will soon happen, if it's not already, here in Australia, to eavesdrop on signals that may be sent our way. But here's an interesting challenge. We surely would have considered ancient Rome a civilization of intelligent people. But had aliens tried to send radio waves to them, no way to receive it, no way to send back, no way to even know what a radio wave is, because the technology had not yet been invented. So our definition of are we alone has to include the fact that they are not only intelligent, but have technology that they can invoke to then send signals across the galaxy. Now, we've only been able to do that for maybe 70 years or so. So, and most of our original signals that have been sent from Earth were quite by accident. Leakage from early television shows. You know, these are the emissaries of our civilization as we go forward. The first wave of radio communication that would be received by aliens, intelligent aliens in another planet. There was an attempt to communicate with us before we had radio waves, and they concluded that there's no sign of intelligent life on Earth. Suppose, not only that, they figured out a cleverer way to communicate than radio waves and radio telescopes, a way that we have yet to invent, because we've only been at it for 70 years. They would still come back with no signal from us. So it's hubristic to even think that what we invent out of the human mind would be the way they would attempt to communicate with us. And I say we're probably not alone because just of how long the universe has been around, how many stars there are in the galaxy, and how many galaxies there are in the universe, and how common the ingredients of life are in the universe. We're not made of rare stuff. You know, if we were made of like an isotope of bismuth, then you could argue that this is a rare thing we got going here on Earth, and it's precious, let's not take it for granted. But we're made of carbon and nitrogen and oxygen and hydrogen. And this is like the most common ingredients in the universe, and they're highly chemically active ingredients to boot. So what is the most complex expression of chemistry that we know? It's called biology. And if biology is an inevitable trajectory of the experimentation that happens naturally on planetary surfaces, then maybe life is inevitable, but is intelligence, as we define it, inevitable? Not much evidence of it in the fossil record other than us, kind of because we defined it. Maybe if whales defined intelligence, we would not be included in their definition, I don't know. But, so these are fascinating questions that require that we relax the bias that we have as being humans on this planet, just to even ask the question in an answerable way, are we alone?